Hello all, happy new year, welcome back to the show. Today we wanted to talk about fresh wort kits, how easy it is to put a brew on with a fresh wort kit. You can put a beer on in less than 5 minutes. What we have in store are a couple of options. The boxes behind me here, all in brewing, made in Brisbane. From a brew pub up there. They are 15 litres in a bladder and it makes 20 litres of beer once you dilute it with 5 litres of water. Also down here in the cubes, the 8 Stacks Brewing. So they are 20 litre cubes. They come from Traralgon, a bit more local. Now, as with anything, there is no one right way of doing it. This is just a method that I have found very useful. I start with a sanitised fermenter. I take my 5 litres of filtered water because I'm using one of the all-in wort kits. You don't necessarily need filtered water if you don't have access to it easily, but as with most things, if you use better quality ingredients, you get a better quality outcome. So I like to tip the water in first because I find that then the wort just mixes really easily. Now these are a bladder inside the box, so while there is a hole in the side of the box, I have found through experience that if you try and use that often, it splashes and I get in trouble. So I like to cut the bladder out of the box very, very carefully, of course, remove the entire bladder and tip it gently that way. The brew I've decided to do today is called the Sabre. It's more of a mid-strength session ale. And really fruity, just another delicious offering from All In. So, behind here we have a little plastic cap which we will pull out. I've found the easiest way is to get the bladder close to the lip of the fermenter and then lift gently. So that's what I'm about to do. Got my water in there, we're ready to mix. Pull out the plastic lug, grab the bottom of the bag, get the tap close to the lip of the fermenter, and lift gently. First time I did this, I tried doing it straight out of the box, splashed all over the kitchen. Unhappy wife. It's also a great way of aerating the wort prior to pitching yeast. Okay, now that we've got our wort in there mixed with the water and aerated, I'm going to take a quick hydrometer reading now that the froth has settled down. I've had my hydrometer sitting in some sanitizer. And that looks to be about 1035, which is bang on where it should be, really. On all of these wort kits, they have a yeast suggestion, or many yeast suggestions, as well as dry hop suggestions, if they would recommend using a dry hop. It's not for everyone, and it's not to say that they require a dry hop, it's more if you like dry hopping, then this is the hops that they would recommend to go with that particular brew. One of the yeasts listed on this particular wort kit is the US05, so now that I've aerated the wort, just going to sprinkle on . Now that we've got the yeast in there, we'll give it a bit of a stir and put the lid on. So we're now ready to close this fermenter up. So I'm going to take my lid . Pop the collar on, get that relatively firm. And as we've previously talked about spooning valves, we'll pop the spooning valve on there and we're going to get this back into our trusty kegerator at the front of the store. We'll keep you updated with how it's going over the next week or so and talk pressure transfers again when she's ready to keg. Thanks for watching, everyone. Cheers.